What is the importance of Brazil for R3 organization?
Well, I think R3 realized very quickly that although Brazil is a huge economy, it's actually a small ecosystem for financial services. So what we see in terms of the opportunity is with very few institutions, we can actually cover a lot of different businesses and a lot of different use cases. So with our three investors, Bradesco, Itaú, and B3, we're actually covering a broad set of businesses and use cases. And that's a very unique situation when we look across the globe.
And talk about Corda platform that R3 is developing. How did it evolve since last year?
Well, so, you know, a year ago, R3 was just starting to decide that we needed to build a distributed ledger specifically for financial services. So when R3 first started out, we were actually just looking and experimenting with the distributed ledgers that existed today, or at the time. So Ethereum and the public blockchain and others. But with our experimentation, very quickly we discovered from our members that they didn't satisfy the unique requirements of regulated financial services. So R3 decided to start from scratch and build from the ground up a distributed ledger that did meet those requirements, and that is Corda.
During our presentation here at CIAB, you say something interesting, that R3 is responsible for developing the platform, but the institution needs to develop services, and you compare it to an operating system and the App Store, for example. Tell a little bit more about it, and what do you think, what are expectations related to companies building those kinds of services, applications?
Yeah, so essentially, the real value in distributed ledger technology is for financial services who are spending so much money on non-differentiating middle and back office processing. For them as an industry to be able to take that from outside their firewalls and put that on a distributed ledger in the cloud and basically share costs across industry, right? So in order to do that, they need a common platform first, and that's where Corda comes in. However, R3 is a small company. We think we know what the platform should look like, but we just can't possibly build out all of the solutions that sit on top of the platform. So what our business plan is to build a platform that works for regulated financial markets and then form partnerships with ISVs, with SIs that actually build the top of stack apps like KYC, payments, trade finance that sit on top of Corda. And, you know, in some cases, the banks have development teams that are going to build these apps themselves. Those might be joint ventures. Those might be internal development builds. In some cases, the banks and financial services will outsource that to ISVs, to system integrators. And we're essentially there to train all of those players on Corda and to help them build those apps, essentially.
And what are expectations related to blockchain adoptions for financial industry for over the couple of years, or
well,
of the
know,
next?
Yeah, so that's a big question, is when will this really take hold? And the reality is we think there's a couple things that what we call kind of the low-hanging fruit that we're going to see go live in the next year or so. So what are the qualities of those? So things like trade finance, where there's no regulator necessarily involved, that's going to, and it's very paper intensive and very manual. We think that's one of the low-hanging fruits where we're going to see some real progress in the next year. You know, in terms of a global cross-border payment system, that's going to take more collaboration. There's more regulators involved. So we think it's going to take some time. But that being said, we can start laying the foundation for that, and that's really what we're doing within R3.